Hello, my dear students. Myself, Anju Tulasi, Assistant Professor, Department of Civil Engineering, SNIT, ADU. On the last class, we discussed about hydraulic jump, length of hydraulic jump, use of hydraulic jump, and types of hydraulic jump. Today, we discuss about the depth of hydraulic jump. So the following assumptions are made in the analysis. The first assumption is, it is assumed that the before and after jump formation, so before and after the jump formation, the flow is considered to be uniform. The flow is considered to be uniform and the pressure distribution is hydrostatic. So before and after the jump formation, the flow is considered to be the uniform and the pressure distribution is hydrostatic. And the second assumption is, the length of the jump is small so that the losses due to friction on the channel floor are small and hence neglected. So the length of the jump which is formed on the channel is considered to be small, so the loss which is due to the friction can be neglected. And the third assumption is, the channel floor is horizontal or the slope, channel floor is horizontal or the slope is so gentle that the weight component of the water mass comprising the jump is negligibly small. So considering the channel floor is horizontal and the slope is gentle and the weight component of the water mass which comprises the jump is taking negligibly small. Now consider a hydraulic jump formed in a horizontal bed. Okay, so consider two sections, section 1-1, section 2-2. So section 1-1 and 2-2 before and after the hydraulic jump. So considering a hydraulic jump is formed in a channel of horizontal bed and consider two sections 1-1 and 2-2 before and after the jump. Let D1 equal depth of flow at section 1-1, D2 equal depth of flow at section 2-2, V1 equal velocity of flow at section 1-1, V2 equal velocity of flow at section 2-2, Z1 bar is the depth of the centroid of area at section 1-1 below the free surface. So it is the depth of the centroid of the area section 1-1 below the free surface. Next, Z2 bar is the depth of the centroid of area at section 2-2 below the free surface. And A1 is the area of cross section at section 1-1 and A2 is the area of cross section at section 2-2. Consider the unit width of channel. So there are three forces which are acting on the mass of water between section 1-1 and 2-2. First one is the pressure force, that is P1 on section 1-1, and second one is the pressure force P2 on the section 2-2, and the third one is the frictional force on the floor of the channel which is considered to be negligible. So these were the three forces which are acting on the mass of the water between section 1-1 and section 2-2. So let Q equal V1 D1 equal V2 D2. Q ennu parna namukku ariyam discharge per unit width. So Q equal discharge per unit width. Okay. V1 is velocity of flow at section 1-1 and D1 is the depth of the flow at section 1-1. V2 is the velocity of the flow at section 2-2 and D2 is the depth of the flow at section 2-2. Okay. So nammal ivide consider cheynathu oru rectangular channel aanu. Okay. Rectangular channel aanu. So rectangular channel of width b aanu. Depth d aanu. Okay. Section 1-1 il varumbom depth endaavu d1 aavu. 2-2 il aanengi depth d2 aavu. Okay. So we have the equation pressure force P1 on section 1-1 equal rho g A1 Z1 bar. Rho g A1 Z1 bar. So A1 nu parayanengil area of the section 1-1. Z1 is the depth of the centroid of the area of the section 1-1. So rectangle channel consider cheyyunnathu unit width ayathu kaaranam rectangle channel area ennu parayunnathu b into d aanu adile unit width kaaranam b endaanu 1 aagum so area equal to 1 into d aanu. Okay, ini rectangle channel inde centroid ennu parayunnathu rectangle channel aanu so z1 bar centroid ennu parayunnathu d1 by 2 aayirikkum centroid.